Hello, my people. Nice to see you again. Nice to be with you again with the latest. As I said to you, if you are following my videos, I will always give you the latest of what is going on. Because I don't talk my own. I don't say anything based on what people are saying. I get my own stuff. I get it direct from the realm of the spirit where life come from. Because if you have God's spirit, you will be able to know all things, but not by your own power. If God decided to show you, decided to tell you, to reveal something to you, he can do that on a good day. You don't force him. So I do wait. When I wait, I wait on him, and he give me something that is hidden, that people did not know that is maybe troubling their life, or what is going on in a nation, or what is going on in an individual life. I can try to bring them to your knowledge for you to know the things that people is like, they don't know what's going on or what's happening, or something. I can tell you according to what I saw or what I see in the realm of the spirit. So, because God's spirit is everywhere, is the master spirit. The spirit of Jesus is the master of all spirits. So, he can decide to show you anything on a good day. He can decide to reveal something to you, something that is hidden that people do not know. He can show you. So, in this video, I'm about to reveal to you the problem. The problem that is rocking the life of these Nigerian singers. They called them P-Square before, but they are no more P-Square. They are separated. They have been having issues. They have been fighting each other. Even on social media, they have been talking about each other, fighting each other. Sit down and bless. I want to tell you, I want to also give them a helping hand to tell them where their problem comes from, when their problems, where it started and when it started. So sit down and listen. As I want to give you this, I want to give you this latest now, according to what I saw in the realm of the spirit. Okay, P-Square, as I told you, they are twins, Nigerian hip hop singer or R&B singer. So two of them, they started well. They are singing. They are making waves. They are happy. They're happy, for each other. But something happened. Something happened. Something happened. Their mother is their backup. Their mother supporting. Their mother is everything to them. Their mother, as I know, their mother is everything to them. So it happened that as they are making a wave, as they are singing their song and growing each day, they decided to feature one American singer. His name, they called him. His name is Rick Ross. Rick Ross. They feature him with Akon. They feature him, and the title of that song is "Beautiful, Beautiful Onyinye." "Beautiful Onyinye" is the name of that song. So I think it's the remix of that song. I don't know whether it's original bit or the remix, but they feature Rick Ross. They feature Rick Ross in that song. So after they feature Rick Ross, in that song, the video, I watched the video, I listened to the whole thing, I watched it. It's very nice. So, but before these two young men, before they will come back to Nigeria, their mother, nothing was wrong with their mother. Nothing was troubling their mother when they left. But before the, after featuring Rick Ross in that "Beautiful Onyinye," for them to get down to Nigeria, their mother doesn't know them anymore. Their mother, a strange sickness hit their mother. Strange sickness hit their mother. Their mother was sick. Along the way, they try to, I don't know, I think maybe later I hear that they feel their mom to outside Nigeria, you know, I don't know. But all I know is that their mother died. Their mother died. Listen very carefully, young man. Listen, you African youths. Listen, you Nigerian youths. Listen, I will be opening your eyes. I'll be talking about Nigerian celebrities, as they call themselves, celebrities. I will be talking about them and what they are into. I will be, this time around, I want to show them, I want them to know that God is everything. God sees everything and God is everywhere. Just listen. You always look down on yourself. You can be talented with somebody that you want to feature in your song. But one thing I find out is that we always look down on ourselves. Why are we always trying to? I want to be seen by Americans. I want to be seen by Europeans. I want to be seen by people on top. I want to do everything to be seen with the big boys and big girls. You are more talented than even somebody that you want to feature. And again, you don't know the person that you want to feature. I pity all you Nigerian singers that is hunting for American singers, because you don't know, if you don't know what you are rushing into, rushing inside. The thing you can't go to, let me tell you something, you can't go to devil without paying tithe. You can't go to devil without paying tithe to the devil. You feature Rick Ross, you want to be famous, you want people to know you. You also must, you know, you have get ready to share in his own suffering, because people think, oh, they are happy, they are big boys, they have they are flaunting cars and money and the women. Let's just join them. Oh, they are big. Don't know that they are suffering, they are poverty stricken, they are crying. You are better off than them. You are better than them. Who is Rick Ross? Who is Rick Ross? People are hunting. What he is worshipping, where he belongs, is what attack your mother. People think they are happy. They are not happy. They hated themselves. They hated themselves. All these American hip-hop singers, American singers, they are into something that they will never tell you until you come inside. When you come inside, you will be like them. You'll be crying day and night. But you will come out, you know, in the open place for people to say you that you are big. You must, you cover up. But in the inside of you, you are crying day and night. What they are living is a fake life. Rick Ross, the devil that is inside of him, the devil that is serving, have to put you guys in the same pain. If people can recall, see that. Since that time, two of you never get each other. If you can recover, see that your mystery, your pains, they taught you one lesson. Pains behind every fail. This is what they simply bring two of you. They brought you inside and unveiled it to you guys. You are now sharing in the same pain that they are into. Day and night. Your mom died after you guys feature Rick Ross. And maybe you people do not know what happened to your mom. Don't know what happened to your mother. But I have to let you know what happened to your mother. You know, I have to make it known to you people to know that this is the time your pain, your misery starts. Your pain starts. Oh, I want to be big boy. I want to be to belong. I want people to notice me. But two of you can tell, if you can tell yourself truth, you know that no matter, you are fronting material things, but there is no peace in the inside of you. There is no unity, because the devil stepped inside, tear two of you apart. You know, use material things and say, okay, you have same material things. But your soul is all I need. Since that time, pains, agony, crying, fighting start to tell you that something, you step your feet in a place that swallow, that eats you up. You step into something that you think something good is there. You don't know that what is there is death. So I also want to read something for you guys to hear. It's important for you to hear. The problem of two of you started right from the moment you feature Rick Ross. The moment you people feature him, you know, in your album, in one of your album called, one of your song called Beautiful Onyinye, your problem in life starts. So I want to show you something. Because you pay 1/10 straight to the devil. You can't go. I think maybe they're happy that you are singing, making money. They want to initiate you to bring you into what they are into. You feature them, want to be known or seen like great, by big boys. They will also tell you that they have something that they are not showing, that they are living a life of pain. That you, they say, welcome on board to show, to share with the same pain. They must cause you one pain. The devil must cause you a pain that you will always remember and be in sorrow and be crying. So I want to show you something in the book of Timothy, 1 Timothy chapter 6. I want to read for you to hear. 1 Timothy chapter 6. The book of 1 Timothy chapter 6 verse 10. For the love of money is a root of all kinds of evil. For the love of fame is a root of all kinds of evil. For which some have strayed from the faith in their greediness and pierced themselves through with many sorrows. I read again for you to understand very clear what I'm saying. I will be talking about so many Nigerian celebrities that is crying on the inside, but they come out and be deceiving you people, fronting fake cars, fronting fake mansions, fronting fake material things, but they are crying. Somebody that is having 100,000 naira is more happy in life than them. I am here to expose a lot of things about Nigerian celebrities as they call themselves. I'll be talking about what I'm saying about them. But I am reading this for you, just listen, about P-Square, Peter and Paul Okoye. I want to let you know why they are in pain since the future recross. For the love of money, God is talking to people now. For the love of money is a root of all kinds of evil, for which some have strayed from the faith in their greediness and pierced themselves through with many sorrows. I met you guys one-on-one at the American Embassy. When I was in Nigeria, I met two of you when two of you are still together. I was with two of you at American Embassy one day. I saw a guy, we stay near each other. I just look at two guys I walk away. This is the time two of you are still together, two of you are still happy, two of you came to the embassy. But in the West, to be world famous, to be known, you are not being contented with what God is doing. You want to feature American big boys. You think they are big boys, they are not big boys. For me, they are nobody. I know them spiritually. And the highest mistake you are making is you are trying to force yourself to be a big boy, to be known, to be seen among the great. You can't go to the house of a strong man without paying a homage. The devil claimed to be a strong man. Bible called him a strong man. Bible said before you can enter into the house of a strong man, for it to tell you that he's powerful. But our God, Jesus, the righteous, is all powerful. is the strongest. Bible says before you can enter into the house of a strong man and plunder his goods, that you must first of all bind the strong man. You can, if you don't bind, if you're not strong than the devil, you go to the devil. He will give you fame. You feature him with aircon. You guys feature him, oh, we are big boys. But they will give you something to nurture. They will give you pains and the agony and the sorrow that you'll be nurturing. Since that time till now, two of you have never get yourself again. They put separation. They put sorrow. Two of you have been fighting. Don't know where it come from. Don't know. The pit of hell now say, good, draw them close. They want to be famed. They want to be known by big boys. Okay, let's give them also. Let's give them something to go home with. You can't go if you go to the devil, you put on a white robe, pure white robe. Before you leave his house, he must take his hand because he is so dirty. He must touch his dirty hands on that white robe, so that people will know that you come to dying with the devil, that you die with him. He must try to paint you to touch that to your white garment, so that people will know that you die with the devil. So this is the problem. If you don't know what's going on between two of you, this is the problem. The thing that the cross is serving, the devil, the demon, people think is ordinary. He is the devil. The cross is devil, and where they belong is strong. Is strong. So you feature him, he draw you inside and say, take this one. That's why your mom died, just died in a tube of ice, mysteriously, bam, something taken away. It happened to this guy. It happened to Kanye West. Many of them. Oh no, I'll be talking about America very soon. Okay, so this is what happened. If you don't know, young man, and many of you that is jumping up and down there, you Africans, you know, you don't know your worth, your value. You want to be known by them, want to be seen, until we begin to live a satisfied life, until we Africans need to know that we are more powerful than all these people who are hunting, trying to be seen or known by them, until you begin to see yourself as somebody. That continent, I always look at the way things is going. We need a change. Well, I'm preparing, I'm planning, and may God help us. Okay, so this is what happened. I just want to tell you in this video what happened to Peter and Paul, Okoye, peace square. Why things never the same again in their life since they feature this American singer, Rick Ross. Many of you, I will also be bringing many of the celebrities that I said to you very soon. Okay, so you have heard this one. This is, if you don't know what's going on, I've told you now. So, all right. Love you guys. Love you so much. See you. Bye-bye.